everybody knows somebody, whether it's a family member, coworker, neighbor, you know, that's been affected by cancer. And to know that that fund is right here, right in your backyard, by helping those that you know, that makes a world of difference.
There's not a person listening on this radio station that can't immediately think of someone close to them that has suffered through cancer or cancer treatment. And we have a story to tell with the Aleva Fund. The Aleva Fund is behind the scenes and helps those patients and those families suffering through cancer treatment and tries to ease their burden while they're going through cancer treatment.
It's just helping your neighbor in need, and someday you might need to use the fund yourself.
The money that we raise goes to patients and patients' families, and that's really important. And it's really important for potential donors to know there's a lot of great charities out there, some of which have an administrative load that comes out of the donations. Right. We don't have.
It goes to a warm blanket. It goes to wigs. It goes for therapy, massage therapy. It goes for emotional therapy. All those dollars or pennies add up.
We had a patient who was homeless. She was in Milford and didn't have health insurance that could really take it far enough to be able to help her with the situation. She didn't have a place to stay in. She didn't have a relative here. And she didn't have any real resources or any money to take care of things that needed to be taken care of separate from her clinical care. So we were able to make arrangements with Hope Lodge in Worcester for a place to stay. So the Aleva Fund paid for transportation to get her there. And we were able to provide her with a grocery store or a gift card so that she could buy all the food that she needed at a reasonable cost to be able to make her meals at Hope Lodge. The Aleva Fund came through, and we were able to solve each of the problems that she had to deal with in order to get the kind of care that she needed.
There isn't a day that goes by that someone doesn't come by to say to me, thank goodness for this center and the Aleva Fund and these staff and these physicians. It's such a gift to this community, and it wouldn't really be possible without all the support that the radio station and the community gives us every year. We're extremely grateful, and it's critical to our continued success and to our ability to take care of these folks.